Ladies and gentlemen, I want to welcome you to our midweek Bible study. And of course, boy, this thing is becoming more and more frightening as we see the unleashing of the seals and judgment upon the earth in the book of Revelation. And as we move into the sounding of the trumpet, where the judgment is now intensified, and we are seeing what will take place during this tribulation period. So welcome to Midweek Bible Study. Those of you from Barrytown, Lilliput, Mount Zion, Fomites, wider Jamaican setting, and the Caribbean. And we, at this time, will move into the time when we pray for people who are challenged and tested. But before we do so, I just want to start with this song, "When the Trumpet of the Lord Shall Sound." And this is done by the Hymn Club. We trust that you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Yes, brothers and sisters, the trumpet of the Lord shall sound. Dead in Christ shall rise, and then they that are alive and remain shall be caught up to meet the Lord in the air. Let us pray. Father, we just magnify you, glorify you, because you're God, and there is none like you, none to be compared with you. Father, we pray for all those who are tested and challenged, those, O God, who encounter some form of difficulties in one way or another. We pray that your Holy Spirit will speak to them, and that whatever is on them that is challenging, testing, and breaking their spirit, that those things will be loose from over them, of their lives, from around their families, in the name of Jesus. We pray for the sick, pray for the needy, we pray for the helpless, we pray for the downtrodden, we pray, O God Almighty, for those who are encountering varied kinds of difficulties, that, Lord, you will set them free and liberate them. Pray for your churches, O God, congregations, those who are challenging one way or another, that your Holy Spirit will speak to them. Pray for Jamaica, for Haiti. Pray for the Caribbean, North American region. O God, the European region, and all the regions, O God, we push back against the philosophies and ideologies and satanic agenda that want to go against the grain of the church and your people and try to despise the name of Jesus. We curse those spirits. We curse those agendas. We neutralize them in the name of Jesus Christ, and we set your people free. Liberate them now from the hands and the clutches of the enemy, in Jesus' name. Call up yonder, I'll be there. Time for the word. Time for the word, brothers and sisters. Let us prepare ourselves to receive of God. Changing me, changing you. Hallelujah. At this time, we turn our Bibles to Revelation chapter 8. We're down to Revelation chapter 8. And trust you will read along with me. And the Bible is speaking. And the Bible says, "And when he had opened the seventh seal, there was silence in heaven about the space of half an hour. And I saw the seven angels which stood before God, and to them were given seven trumpets. And another angel came and stood at the altar, having a golden censer, and there was given unto him much incense, that he should offer it with the prayers of all saints upon the golden altar which was before the throne. And the smoke of the incense which came with the prayers of the saints ascended up before God out of the angel's hand. And the angel took the censer and filled it with fire of the altar and cast it into the earth. And there were voices and thunderings and lightnings and earthquake. And the seven angels which had the seven trumpets prepared themselves to sound. The first angel sounded, and there followed hail and fire mingled with blood, and they were cast upon the earth, and the third part of trees were burnt up, and all green grass was burnt up. And the second angel sounded, and as it were, a great mountain burning with fire was cast into the sea, and the third part of the sea became blood. And the third part of the creatures which were in the sea and had life died. And the third part of the ships were destroyed. And the third angel sounded, and there fell a great star from heaven, burning as it were a lamp. And it fell upon the third part of the rivers, and upon the fountain of the waters. And the name of the star is called Wormwood. And the third part of the waters became wormwood. And many persons died of the waters because they were made bitter. And the fourth angel sounded, and the third part of the sun was smitten, and the third part of the moon, and the third part of the stars, so as the third part of them was darkened, and the day shone not for a third part of it, and the night likewise. And I beheld and heard an angel flying through the midst of the heaven, saying with a loud voice, Woe, woe, woe to the inhabitants of the earth, by reason of the other voices of the trumpet of the three angels which are yet to sound. This is the word of God. Pray that the voice of God will speak to you in this hour, and that you will be transformed by the word of God. Yes, brothers and sisters, as we indicated in the study of the previous chapters, the chronological outlay of the series of judgment would be disrupted with what we call insets and parenthetical references. And we see the first of such inset in chapter 7, as we had the six of the seals were open in chapter 6, and then the angels were asked to hold their hands so that there would be the sealing of 144,000 from 144,000, 12,000 from each tribe of Israel. Now, the final seal will not be open, we said, until we reach chapter 8. So, therefore, now chapter 8 begins where chapter 6 would have left off. Chapter 7 is an inset. For, as we said, six of the seals are already open in chapter 6, and the seventh one, which was delayed to facilitate the sealing of the 144,000, was now to be open and manifest, and then later would be expanded into the seven trumpets, which was to be the next series of judgment, which was to follow. So here, how the chapter 8 opens up. And when he had opened the seven seals, there was silence in heaven for about the space of half an hour. And verse 2 says, And I saw the seven angels which stood before God. To them were given seven trumpets. And another angel, verse 3, came and stood at the altar, having a golden censer. And there was given unto him much incense that he should offer for the prayers of all the saints upon the golden altar which was before the throne. Verse 4 says, And the smoke of the incense which came with the prayers of the saints ascended up before God out of the angel's hand. Now, the silence that we see in verse 1 of chapter 8 in heaven is said to be symbolic and has some direct correspondence with the Jewish custom where there was an interval in their worship during which time the priest would go into the holiest of all to offer incense on the behalf of the people. This was done in silence since the judgment of God could fall upon the priest and they would have to use a cord and pull him out. And this is why the garments of the priest was designed with little bells on the end of the gown so that they could hear the movement of the priest when he was offering the incense upon the altar of incense beyond the veil. And so this is precisely what was happening here, because you know that the tabernacle in the wilderness and or the temple which came later was designed as a replica of what the worship setting of heaven is like. So the silence is very symbolic of that. While the priest would have taken the incense, in this case the angel, and offered it upon the altar. Now the incense is representative of the prayers of the saints, which the angel here bear before God, and would be followed by the sounding of the series of trumpet, which is symbolic of judgment, which is God's response to the prayers of the saints. It is strongly believed that the incense here represents the prayers of the saints under the altar, as we see in chapter 6 and verse 9 to 10, when the souls underneath the altar who were beheaded for the word of God, they were saying to the Lord, how long will it take you to revenge our blood upon the enemies? The throwing of the incense on the earth mixed with fire is symbolic, it is said, of God's response. Right? So the angel would have taken the fire of the altar, put it in the censer, and then he would take that fire from the censer and pour it upon the earth, which is symbolic of the answer of God to the prayers of the saints with judgment through the blowing of the trumpet. Now, you know that God always liked the sweet fragrance of the prayers that come up to him when burnt. Like that. A vivid example is with Noah after the flood. He built an altar, offered a sacrifice to the Lord. And when the Lord smelled the sweet fragrance that was coming from the altar, the Bible says that he made a covenant with Noah, which is a rainbow, that he would never again destroy the earth with a flood. So hear what verse 5 says of chapter 8. And when the angel took up the censers and filled it with the fire of the altar and cast it into the earth, and there were voices and thunderings and lightnings and earthquake. So it is believed that God responded to the prayer with the penalty of the unbelievers and those who persecuted those who were under the altar, beheaded for the name of Jesus. The first four judgments are physical that resulted from the blowing of the trumpet, and they are more drastic than the previous judgments that was poured out in the form of the seals, and are directed against the earth, the sea, the rivers, the heavenly bodies, since these are the objects of pagan worship throughout the centuries. Notice that the same thing happened in Egypt when God poured out judgment upon Pharaoh and the Egyptians when they held the people of Israel in bondage. Now, it is believed that there were 10 plagues that were poured out upon Egypt, and each one was against each of the god of Egypt, like the river god. There was a god of the river Nile, there was a god of frog, the sun god, and so on. And each of these plagues were directed against the god, because if these things were worshipped and then they turn around on the people, then it would have demonstrated to them that these were not really gods as they thought. Now in verse 7, the first angel sounded, and there followed hail and fire mingled with blood, and they were cast upon the earth. And the third part of trees were burnt up, and all green grass was burnt up. Verse 8 says, and the second angel sounded, as it were, a great mountain burning with fire was cast into the sea, and a third part of the sea became blood. And the third part of the creatures which were in the sea and had life died, and the third part of the ship was affected and destroyed. Then verse 10, it says, and the third angel sounded, and there fell again the star from heaven, burning as it were a lamp, and it fell upon the third part of the rivers and upon the fountains of water. And the name of the star is called Wormwood, and a third part of the waters became wormwood, and many persons died of the waters because they were made bitter. Verse 12, and the fourth angel sounded, and the third part of the sun was smitten, and a third part of the moon, and a third part of the stars. And so as a third part of them were darkened, the day shone not for a third part of it, and night likewise. Notice a similarity of some of these judgments which took place in Egypt, as I implied before. And in Exodus 9 and verse 13 to 25, we'll give you a clear picture of that. In the judgment upon the sea, two things were affected. One, the marine life, which died. And so that would affect the seafood community, those who depend greatly upon seafood, to survive. Secondly, the ships were destroyed, thus affecting trade, commercial activities such as imports and exports, food supply, gas, oil, which we normally bring into the country, and the whole trade community between nations and nations would be affected. The other judgment in the falling of the stars, which affected the water supply, brothers and sisters, would indicate that we can live for a long time without food, but it is difficult to live without water. And this is why this judgment is critical. So the trees are destroyed, the greenery is destroyed, the sea is to an extent destroyed, the fishing community, the fish life and marine life, the shipping industry is affected, and now the water supply is affected. Now, in the blowing of the fourth trumpet, the light will be also affected. The sun will not shine. The moon will not shine. The stars refuse to shine. And Christ did prophesy of these things in Luke 21, verse 15, that, and there shall be signs in the sun and in the moon and the stars upon the earth, distress of nations, and so on and so forth. Now, brothers and sisters, this will be the actual fulfillment when the sun, the moon refused to shine. Remember now in Egypt that it also happened that the sun refused to shine for 3 days and 3 nights, but yet the people of God were not affected. As the sounding of the trumpet continued. And the first four trumpets sounded. After that, an angel was seen flying through the midst of the heaven, declaring, "Woe, woe, woe." Three woes, indicating that the last three trumpets that are to come, brothers and sisters, through the sound, but through the blowing of these angels, will be more severe, and the consequences of the judgment will be more severe than the previous trumpets that sounded. So look, we had the affecting of nature, the trees, the birds, everything affected, the greenery, and then to have the sea affected, the shipping industry, commercial activity, sea turning into blood, the ship can't travel. If you have dead fish and dead creatures from the sea and the water is blood, then imagine the stench. The ship can't travel in that. Then we have the water and all the rivers and tributaries become bitter, is not palatable. And then we have the sun refusing to shine, the moon, the stars, there's no light in the sky. It's pure darkness over the earth for a number of days. And then what the angels are saying, woe, it is believed that each of these woes has a direct link to each of the remaining three trumpets that are to sound. And I think it is implied in verse 13. He says, "And behold, I heard an angel flying through the midst of the heavens, saying with a loud voice, woe, woe, woe to the inhabitants of the earth by reason of the other voices of the trumpet of the three angels which are yet to sound." Brothers and sisters, each of these sounding of trumpets and outpouring of the wrath gets more severe and severe. Next time we come, we'll look at chapter 9 for the sounding of the remaining trumpets, or two of the remaining trumpets, and then we'll see where we go from there. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you. He lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Shalom, brothers and sisters. Nothing lacking, nothing wanting. Peace.